Hello, John Talley here with Partzilla.com. So let's say you've been looking into getting a dirt bike and you found several units that you like, but you're torn. Do you go with a two-stroke or a four-stroke? Well, that's an age-old question in the dirt bike world. And if you want to know a little bit more about the pros and cons of each, we can go check it out. So let's go. Okay, some of you may be getting ready to buy your fifth or sixth dirt bike, and you already know all this. But some of you may be brand new to the dirt bike market and don't know, well, the basics. So what is, quote, a stroke? Well, that's the movement of the piston from one end of the cylinder to the other, either in the up or down stroke. Now, inside the cylinder, there are four major events that happen. First, you have the intake, when the air and fuel are drawn into the cylinder. Then you have compression, where the piston squeezes the fuel and the air inside of the cylinder. Third, you have the ignition or power stroke. That's when the compressed fuel-air mix is ignited. And last, you have exhaust. That's when the leftover gases are pushed out of the cylinder. And then it starts all over again with the intake. Now, in a four-stroke, one movement of the piston, either up or down, is essential for each of those four events. Now, it draws in that fuel-air mixture through the intake valve, pulls it into the cylinder as the piston is going down, piston comes up, both valves close, ignites, piston's going back down, comes back up, that's when the exhaust valve opens and forces out all that burnt up air fuel mixture, also known as exhaust. Now when you're working with a two-stroke, well, two of those events happen in each movement of the piston. The intake and the exhaust happen as the piston moves from top to bottom, and compression and ignition happen as the piston moves up toward the top of the cylinder. Now, it accomplishes this by having ports at different heights, as well as a transfer port that actually goes through the crankcase. But what's really important that you need to draw from this is it only takes one revolution for an entire combustion cycle. And that's what we're really here to talk about. One rotation for a two-stroke, two rotations for a four-stroke. Two strokes, four. So basically, that's how they work. But what does that mean from a practical standpoint? Well, the four-stroke will have a broader power band, so you won't need to shift quite as much, and generally, you will have less maintenance. Although when you do have maintenance, it's going to be quite a bit more expensive. But that comes with power and weight gain and cash. The four-stroke is a bit heavier, and when you do need to do some of those repairs, it's going to be more expensive. It's just a fact of life. Now, with a two-stroke, they're going to be lighter, well, because they have fewer moving parts. This means they're more compact, and they can spin up a little quicker than a four-stroke. A 125cc two-stroke will pack about the same punch as a 250 four-stroke. So for every cc you add, you're getting about twice the power. So they're going to need a little bit more maintenance, and that narrow power band might not suit inexperienced riders who don't want to shift all the time. So which one should you pick? Well, consider how much you want to shift and how you want the power delivered. Now, if you don't want to be shifting all the time in the narrow two-stroke band, then a four-stroke may be the way to go. But if you're looking for a light, punchy bike, and you're not afraid to get your hands dirty with a little more maintenance, the two-stroke might be just the right choice for you. Now, this may be a foregone conclusion as to which way you're going to go, because let's face it, because of Doug Henry, the two-stroke market isn't quite what it used to be when he and Yamaha pretty much revolutionized the motocross market in 1998 with the original YZ400F. Well, everybody started to follow suit. Now, there still are a couple of manufacturers that still cater toward the two-stroke market, especially on the smaller displacement units. I know that Kawasaki, as well as Yamaha has a full line of motocross bikes in the two-stroke formula. And then you also have the European models, especially KTM, GasGas, that crew. And they mainly cater toward the off-road or enduro series, because that's where you want something really light and really peppy, because you're dealing with very technical terrain. On the motocross side, well, four strokes, they dominate. But that doesn't mean that you can't be competitive if you want to bring a two-stroke. It's what, well, just about everybody in my age grew up riding. So it's just a fact of life. It just really boils down to, well, which one do you feel more comfortable on, and how are you going to use the machine primarily? So both have their pros and both have their cons. It just kind of depends on what you're looking for in the bike, how are you going to use it, and what type of investment you want to make on it when it comes to the maintenance. More maintenance on the two-stroke, or expensive maintenance on the four-stroke. And speaking of maintenance, if you need parts for your machine or anything else, why don't you come see us at Partzilla.com and we can get you taken care of. If you have any questions or comments about this video, leave them in the section below and I'll do my best to answer them. We just want to say thank you for shopping here with us at Partzilla, and we will see you in the next video. Y'all have a great day.